like the storm that cuts a path. It breaks your will. It feels like that. You think you're lost, but you're not lost on your own. You're not alone. I will stand by you. I will help you through when you've done all you can do and you can't call. I will dry your eyes. I will fight your fight. I will hold you tight, and I won't let go. It hurts my heart to see you cry.
celebrate the life and witness of our departed friend and mother and grandmother and all the other things of Sister Sandiford. The Seniors Fellowship of Pointy Blood Assembly will now render these two songs as our tribute to her. We do hope that you enjoy it as the minister in Jesus' name.
Oh, yes.
Please stand. I am the resurrection and the life, saith the Lord. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. I know that my Redeemer liveth, and that he shall stand at the latter day upon the earth. And though after my skin worms destroy this body, yet in my flesh shall I see God, whom I shall see for myself, and my eyes shall behold, and not another. We brought nothing into this world, and it is certain that we can carry nothing out. The Lord gave, and the Lord have taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord. Lord, let me know my end and the number of my days, that I may be certified how long I have to live. Behold, thou hast made my days as it were a span long, and my age is even as nothing in respect of thee. And verily, every man liveth is altogether vanity. For a man walketh in a vain shadow, and disquieteth himself in vain. He heapeth up riches and cannot tell who shall gather them. And now, Lord, what is my hope? Truly, my hope is even in thee. Bless God. Good evening and welcome to the Pouring the Blood Assembly. As we come to fellowship and to give God thanks for the life and witness of our departed sister, I take this opportunity to extend condolences on behalf of the management of this church and the full Pouring the Blood Assembly family, of which our sister Sandiford was a member. At this time, we want you to join the worship team as we sing "It Is Well With My Soul," after which our Elder Brown will pray for this service.
Sorrows like sea His presence this afternoon. Father, we say thank you. You're a God that is able and more than able. And as I stand to lift this service before you, Lord, the family members, the loved ones, all that pertains to this sermon, this ceremony this afternoon, we commit this time to you this afternoon, Lord, as we celebrate the life of Onita Sandiford. May your blessing be upon this service. We've come here to celebrate her life, Lord. We've come to honor you and to lift up your name. Bless the proceedings this afternoon. Lord, we thank you that we can say, it is well with my soul. And Father, we know that your cross carried it all the sins. So we ask God for your hand to come among us this afternoon. Let the Spirit of the living God touch hearts. Lord, release grace. Lord, let somebody receive the strength they need to carry on and to go the journey. I pray, God, that you will speak to our hearts. Lift us up this afternoon, God, to a place where we can arise and we can stand in the midst of the loss of loved ones, in the midst of difficulties that we see going on in this time. Lord, we know that you are with us. We thank you for being here. Your presence is here this afternoon. Yeah. And Lord, we've come to glorify your name. We've come to celebrate Jesus. And we thank you for coming and speaking to us. Bless the woman of God. Bless her as she do this service, as she minister your word. Let nothing, oh God, be done out of vain glory. But may you receive the glory this afternoon. And we give you thanks. In Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Bless God. We remain standing for the first scripture reading. Psalm 23 is going to be read by some young people, grandchildren, I believe. So let's remain standing as they read.
The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever.
Amen. You may be seated. Again, I take the opportunity to welcome those of you who came in after we started, and to say, express sympathy. I apologize for the absence of our senior pastor who was out of the island. But today we are here to give thanks. I want to recognize some of our pastors in the midst. I know you're seated all in different places, but pastors, we have many pastors here who are actually blood relatives of our departed sister, Reverend Ulysse and Griffith, and our Reverend, oh Lord, I always say Junior. The name is running from me. It is in this here somewhere. Eversell, right. Bless you. I see our evangelist Francis and our own elders from Pouring the Blood Assembly, Elder Murray, Reverend Messiah, way in the back. God bless you, and we do hope that you enjoy this service. It is not, we are not mourning as though we have no hope. We are celebrating a life that was lived for Christ, because we know that she came to that place where she established a relationship. And so she is at rest with him. We're going to continue in our service with tributes. We're going to have a poem by Edwina Walks, and that is going to be followed with a song by her daughter, Coral. So Edwina will do her poem, and then Coral is going to sing.
Good afternoon, church. I will dedicate this poem on behalf of Suzanne and the extended family. Gran, God saw you were getting tired and a cure was not to be. So he put his arms around you and he whispered, come to me. With teary eyes, they watch you. and they saw you passed away. Although they loved you dearly, they could not make you stay. A golden heart stopped beating, hard-working hands at rest. Although your hearts are broken, we all know that God knows best. Continue to rest in peace, Gran.
A good afternoon to the church. I want to welcome each and every one this afternoon. As this was my mother's wish before she passed, that she asked that I should sing, but I pray right now for God's strength. And I want to acknowledge two of my co-workers. Thank you very much for being here. God bless each and every one of us. This song title, this song brings hope and comfort, because in these difficult times, we know that we have to take the name of Jesus with us wherever we go. We need to take the name of Jesus wherever we go. Take the name of Jesus with you, child of sorrow and of woe. It will joy and comfort give you. Take it then wherever you go. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Take the name of Jesus ever as a shield from every snare. If temptations round you gather, breathe that holy name and pray. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh, how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Take then, the precious name of Jesus, how it thrills our soul with joy. When his loving arms receive us, and his sounds our tongues employ. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. At the name of Jesus bowing, falling prostrate at his feet, King of kings in heaven will crown him when their journey is complete. Precious name, precious name, oh how sweet, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven. Precious name, oh how sweet, hope of earth and joy of heaven.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless God. Precious name, oh how sweet. Is the hope of every believer. Hallelujah. Thank you. We bless God for Carol, because we here in the seniors ministry, we do our best to follow up our shut-ins. But we know that if our sister Sandiford was having a challenge and she needed some extra prayer, we could depend on Carol to make sure that we know Mommy needs prayer right now. This is happening, that is happening. So we thank you for the interest that you have exhibited and demonstrated in the care of your mom to make sure that she was always lifted before the throne of God. And maybe it's those prayers that have kept her all this time. So give God some praise for her life. Hallelujah. We're going to continue in tribute. We have tribute in song by Sabrina Watson and Kieran, and that is going to be followed by the second scripture reading from 1 Corinthians chapter 15, verses 51 to 58. Sabrina?
Reach out and touch the Lord as He passed by. You'll find He's not too busy to hear your heart's cry. He is passing by this moment, your needs to supply.
Luan and Jason, Javon, sorry. Oh, the John and Javon, sorry.
Good afternoon. Corinthians 15, 51. Corinthians chapter 15, 51 to 58. Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed. In a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. For the trumpet will sound, and at the death we will be raised incorruptible, and we shall be changed.
For this corruptible
must be put on incorruption, and this mortal must be put on immortality. So when this corruptible has been put on incorruption, and this mortal has been put on immortality, then shall be brought to pass the saying that is written, death is swallowed up in victory. O death, where is your sting? O Hades, where is your victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved brethren, be steadfast, immovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord, knowing that your labor is not in vain. Thanks a lot.
Here endeth the reading. Thank you, young man. Bless God for them. Put your hands together for them, please. I believe it took effort to do that, so we bless you. Hallelujah. We are going to now invite you to stand again as we invite the worship team to come back and lead us in the session of worship. We're celebrating a life that loves worship. And so we need you to free yourselves and worship the Lord in the beauty of holiness. We are going to be doing At the Cross and Someday and another adjoin. I can't remember what that is, but it is going. We are going to bless God this afternoon. Amen?
Amen.
Listen, if you are in this house and you know how to worship, if you are in this house and you are a believer, we need you to worship the Lord. It is a time of grief and sadness, yes, but when a soul has departed in Christ, we can still rejoice, amen, in the midst of our sorrows. So just worship God as the team comes back to you.
Cheers.
trouble and trial.
When I get home on the other side, I'm going to shake my hand with the elders. Tell all the people good morning. Sit down beside my Jesus. Sit down and press on the one. It's so good. When trouble and trial, when I get home.
When I get over on the other side, I'm going to shake my hand with the elders and tell the saints good morning. Sit down beside King Jesus. Hallelujah. 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 We praise God. We serve a great, big, wonderful God. Our sister Shell is lying there. Oh, my God. But she is with Jesus. Hallelujah. No longer trials. No longer tests. No longer pain. And the only way you can have that is when Jesus become your Savior and you allow him to be your Lord. God bless you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a praise in the house. Give the Lord a praise in this house. Hallelujah. His grace is sufficient. His grace makes a difference. Hallelujah. Salvation belongs to our God. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord another time, and we're going to have some other tributes now. We have first a speech from our Charlene Jones, and then our Pastor Aversil Griffith. These are all nephews of our departed sister. Sister Jones. Sorry, niece and nephew.
Good afternoon, church. We are honored to be here this afternoon. Concur with the protocol that has been established, but I would like to say I do give honor to God and to all the officials here and to the family members, my family, and to the angel of this church. As we celebrate the homegoing of our beloved Aunt Precious, I want to look back on what she meant to me and a few things that made her so special. She was quiet, she was pleasant, and always had a smile. I cannot remember any occasion when Aunt Precious got really angry or upset. She was the one you can go to and be yourself without criticism. She knew scriptures, and one of the scriptures she taught me as a child has now become my favorite, Psalm 34. I will bless the Lord at all times. and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. I can almost hear her voice in my ear with verse 11. Come ye children, hearken unto me. I will teach you the fear of the Lord. She was the first one to move from to the city, which made it convenient to drop in on her before going to my classes at the Evening Institute or after work. Now residing in the USA on my visits home, Aunt Precious always came to see me, bring the goodies she knew I couldn't get overseas. When she could no longer travel, she made sure that someone got them to me. Regardless of how short my stay was here in the island, Aunt Precious got a visit. Everdeen and I had a good laugh recently on a Zoom meeting. The first person she would ask for is my husband, Adrian. Aunt Precious was a lovely, loving, and caring aunt, gone but not forgotten. Everyone should have an Aunt Precious in their life. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I have been entrusted with the most formidable task to deliver this eulogy or appreciation in honor of my dear Aunt Gwendolyn Onitha Sanford. On behalf of Lawrence Marshall, who was unable to attend today, it was her request before her passing that I carry out this responsibility, and I'm honored to serve in this capacity. Gwendolyn was born on September 24, 1934 in White Hills, St. Andrew, to the late Elizabeth and Nathaniel Watson. She had three other siblings who have preceded her in death. My beloved Aunt Precious was affectionately known in the family as Aunt Precious, Miss Eiffel, and Sandy. She acquired the name Precious when, as a baby, she was very ill and the doctors did not think she would make it. Her mother was advised to take her home where she would lie down and die in peace. Her mother, believing and not losing hope that her beautiful baby would survive, nursed her back to health with love and affection, calling her her little Precious. Over the years, Aunt Precious demonstrated the characteristics of being loving and caring that matched perfectly with the name. And soon everyone knew and called her Precious. She had a beautiful disposition and carried a sweet smile. In her earlier years, Precious met and married Winfield Eiffel, who is also deceased. That marriage produced one son, Vincent. She was by profession a seamstress who was well known for her craft. All the dresses she designed had to have pockets. Precious sold her dresses in the Pine housing area and also at Coconut Creek on the West Coast, where she met and married her late husband, Sandiford. Precious was also an excellent baker of sweet bread and pone. She was well known as the weather woman in the family, as she took great pride in being able to follow up with the government officials to predict the weather conditions in the area. She knew the Met Office hotline number by heart and kept abreast with them to assure that the information passed on to her family members was reliable. Her advice was always to make sure we didn't get wet and try to get home before the rain comes. Aunt P loved family and family get-togethers. Her greatest passion was to be able to celebrate her birthday with family and friends. Every year, she made sure everyone was invited to the party and or spend some time with her, even if it was just for a short while. She would always say, "You gotta come and pass all the time with me. I'm not sure if I will be here next year." For sure, everyone tried to respect her wishes. She had many sayings which we have become to love and even use now that we are adults. One of her favorites was, "All I want is a little love." She loved She showed her appreciation and expressed her gratitude by singing our praises. One of her nephews recalls how she reminded him how much she enjoyed the drive they took together in the country parts on her 70th birthday. And P had a healthy laugh and a good sense of humor. Even while planning her funeral, she was still so joyful. After she gave her instructions as to what she wanted, someone in the group asked what she was to do, and laughingly she responded, "Oh, you won't be able to do anything." Everyone burst out laughing. That's our Aunt P, full of life and laughter. Aunt P was the mother of three children, Vincent, Valerie, and Everdeen. She has also left behind seven grandchildren, nine great-grandchildren, one great-grandchild, several nieces, nephews, and a host of other relatives. Her children carries her in their heart and lovingly remembers her as being kind, loving, and supportive. Affectionately called Ma, encourage us to further our education for our personal development and advancement. She reinforced us in the principle to serve God and always covered us in prayer. We could always know by the look in her eyes when she was pleased or displeased with us. It took just one look. Vincent, her son, remembers his mother as being very supportive. In his words, "She sent me to technical school to ensure that I would be able to support myself and my family. I will miss my mom, and she will be forever in my heart." Karen holds dear memories of her Saturday walks through the pine with Gran, witnessing Gran's determination to provide for her family without a formal education made a lasting impact on Karen. It exemplified Gran's exceptional love and selflessness, particularly regarding Karen's education. Despite being the youngest in her family, Gran embraced her responsibilities and learned a trade to help support her loved ones. Karen vividly recalls Gran's tireless hours at the sewing machine, creating beautiful dresses she sold on the beach. Karen sometimes accompanied Gran on walks through the Pine housing area, enduring the scorching sun to deliver orders or showcase her creations. Gran's resilience, determination, and unwavering support have left an indelible mark on Karen's life, instilling the value of education and providing opportunities Gran did not have herself. Karen pays tribute to Gran's immeasurable influence, grateful for her sacrifices and unwavering love that paved the path to Karen's personal growth and success. Shakia fondly recalls the countless tales Gran would share about her upbringing in the countryside. Each time Gran's storytelling transported Kia to another time and place, painting vivid pictures that made her feel like she was experiencing those moments firsthand. Despite having heard these stories on numerous occasions, Kia remained captivated and eager, hanging on to every word. Among the tales were anecdotes of Gran's daily routines, like fetching water from before school and encountering mischievous dogs during her journey back home in the countryside. Sabrina says she will remember her affectionately as Mama, a kind and loving person to all, a one of a kind. Above all, Sabrina will remember her face lit up into a gigantic smile whenever I visited and we hugged and chatted. Ma would make sure to have some spare change ready to give my kids to buy ice cream whenever we came visiting. We love you, Ma, and you will truly be missed. Love always, Sabrina, Javon, LaJean, and Shira. I may have pronounced that. Shiara, amen. Kiara, thanks, amen. And I hope I don't mess up the other one. Ashania, amen, recalls the many fond memories with Mademoiselle, as I always used to call her. In any given situation, she would wait until it was just two of us and say to me, "Come, let we talk, cause you is the only one that got sense." We would laugh before getting into deep conversation. Mademoiselle trusted my opinion on all matters, even asking to find out what I think, caused a new pimple on her face. She took my advice and trusted my opinion before making any decisions. Susan remembers Ma as her everything, including mother, friend, confidant. Susan was always intrigued by the window sessions Ma loved so much. You could always pass and see her peeping through one of the windows. If someone should pass by on the opposite side of the road, out of her view, she would frantically call us and we would run through the house in a panic just to hear her say, "Who's that walking up there?" Suzanne will sorely miss Ma. Niasha, did I get that right? Niasha remembers Gran calling them to do special favors, like put these things one side or thread this needle for Ma. When they were finished with the chores, she would laugh and say, I owe you 25 cents. She was always looking for a good laugh. Ma, Aunt P, precious, you will be sorely missed, but you will live in our hearts forever. Your kindness, humility, and love of the Lord have impacted our lives beyond measure. Love you, Ma. Rest in his loving arms. Our family would like to take the opportunity to say a big thank you to God for the 88 years he allowed Aunt P to spend with us. A special thank you to everyone who took the time to be here with us today. Thank you for the many phone calls, cards, expressions of sympathy, and the many prayers. Please continue to keep us in your prayers. Thanks in particular to her long life friends who stood by her side, Sonia, Pepsi, Miss Grant, and Miss Brown, who spent time chatting with Aunt P on the phone. A special thank you to the Red Cross for their service and to the National Assistance Board staff. To the pastors and members of Power in the Blood Church, please accept our humble gratitude for all you have done. Thanks to E. Pamela Small Funeral Home and staff for the great job you have done taking care of our beloved mother, grandmother, and friend. May Gwendolyn, aka Precious, soul rest in peace and rise in glory. God bless you.
Praise God. Everybody had a chance to say what they remember about our departed Aunt Precious, so we bless God for that privilege. Can you stand as we set our hearts to hear what the Lord will say to us for a few moments? We can just sing that little verse of "Hide Me Now." It's not in your sheet, Brother Dwayne. Hallelujah.
Heavenly Father, we thank you for the time we have already spent in your presence, for the time of reflection on the life of your daughter. We thank you for the privilege of knowing her and loving her and sharing time with her. And as we celebrate her coming home to you, we come to ask you right now to minister to our hearts a word that would comfort, a word that would strengthen, a word that would encourage, and more so a word that would challenge. I give myself to you as a servant, ask that you would be pleased to use me. Take all honor, all glory, and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Please be seated in the presence of the Lord. For the next few moments, I just want us to take a look back at one of the verses of Psalm 23, which we have already read. I'm going to be looking at verse 4. And the topic is the Lord my comfort. Verse 4 says, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. This psalm is written by King David, a man who, before he became a king, was a shepherd. And now he is using his shepherd experience to express how he feels about the relationship that he has with his God. He likens God's care, God's protection, and God's provision, and God's guidance of him to what he himself did for his sheep. And so today, as we celebrate our precious's life, I recall having the privilege of hearing her repeat Psalm 23 while she was on hospital bed as her favorite psalm. And you will recognize that it was already chosen as part of today's Bible reading. So when I heard that, it told me something about this woman. It told me that just like the psalmist David, notwithstanding what she would have gone through in life, notwithstanding what challenges she would have been facing, she knew where to go for her comfort. She knew the one who is faithful and just. She knew the one who never gives up or fails to fulfill his promises. He never breaks a promise. And so as we celebrate her life, I want to challenge us, those of us who already know the Lord and those of us who don't, to just like she did, see the Lord Jesus Christ as your comfort. What am I asking you to do? The Bible dictionary defines comfort as encouragement, either by words or by the presence of another to help in the time of need. So David acknowledged the Lord as his comfort, making that point, I will fear no evil. Why? Because thou art with me. Your presence is ever near. I am in your presence, so I will not fear. We know as parents, and not only parents, but adults, if we have a child and the child is fearful about something, sometimes we can assure them that we are here. And just by knowing that they have somebody with them, that fear is alleviated. So I want to suggest to us this evening that just as we find comfort in earthly men and women because we trust them, we need to know Jesus Christ and to know him and to trust him just like a child would trust an adult or a parent. David's position of comfort from the presence of God is also borne out in other scriptures. Isaiah 41:10 says, we hear these words, fear thou not, for I am with thee. When we know that the Lord is with us, we can take comfort. Jesus Christ himself was sending out his disciples. He was giving them a task. We consider it a mammoth task. He also knew, he said, I'm sending you out there among wolves. I'm sending you out on a mission. But he assured them, go, I'm with you always, even to the end of the earth. I'm going to assure us that we can hold on to this afternoon, that when we are in the presence of God, we can be comforted. Psalm 46, the Lord is our ever-present help in the time of trouble. So why do we need comfort? We need comfort because life happens. Life happens to everybody. We don't decide if sickness is going to come. We don't decide if we're going to butt up on somebody who is going to try to attack us. We don't decide if somebody is going to say something negative about us. We don't decide if we go to work and we're going to have somebody who will just get angry for nothing, no reason at all. Life happens. People get married expecting to live until death and marriages break. Life happens. And life, when life happens, it brings pressure, it brings pain. But we thank God this afternoon we are talking about a Jesus who, amidst all the troubles and the tribulations and the challenges of life, we can find comfort in here. When we know God, the way we handle our challenges, the way we handle our troubles is different from the one who doesn't know God, because we know where to run to. Our precious knew where to run to. Hallelujah. In John chapter 16:33, we see Jesus. He's preparing to leave. And he gives the disciples a lot of instructions. And at the end of them, he said, I tell you this because in this life, you're going to have trouble. Amen. So I'm telling you all of these things, how to find peace, because it is not anything that you can avoid. In this life, you're going to have trouble. The prince of the world, the evil one, that is his job. But they come to tell us where he is doing his job. We have a job to do, we who are children of God. We will lift up the name of Jesus. We will stand on his promises. We will declare that he is our comfort. And so when the enemy is doing what he is doing, we will run in to him for our shelter. He says trouble is going to come. And in addition to that, in John 14, he said, yeah, I'm leaving, but I'm giving you peace. I'm not giving you peace like the world gives you. I am giving you peace. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. I say that is encouragement. That is encouragement to you this evening who may be feeling the grief and the loss of Granny, Mommy, whatever she was to you. But there is comfort in Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. One songwriter puts it this way. I have somebody with me to bear my heavy load. I have somebody with me all the way. Though troubles overtake me along life's journey road, I have somebody with me all the way. Life happens, but when Jesus is with us, we can face the storms. When he is in the boat, we can consider ourselves safe. So how do we get there? How do we as a people living in a world of trouble on every hand and side get to a place of peace? Get a place of comfort? Our sister, before she closed off her worship set, she reminded us, it starts with salvation. What we will learn from the psalmist is that it begins with a relationship. A relationship established with Jesus Christ through that great gift of salvation. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever, and that means everybody hearing me this evening, will believe in him, shall not perish, but have everlasting life. Everlasting life don't start here. Everlasting life starts when we begin and establish our relationship with Jesus Christ. We have to have it while we are here, so when we get there, we know we're going down with it. It can't happen this evening. I can't sing loud enough, pray hard enough, talk enough about precious to put her any place if she didn't die in Christ. But once you die in Christ, you know you can rise in glory. Can we give the Lord a praise in this house? Hallelujah. So your first step in being able to establish this, receive this comfort, is to establish a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ. And then you need to desire his presence. You can't just How many people want to be in the presence of somebody that they don't have a relationship with? Tell me, anybody? If you don't really want to be around people that you don't really got a relationship with. And so when you have established a relationship with Jesus Christ, you want to be in his presence. This same David said, one thing have I desired of the Lord, I like going after it. That I will dwell in the house of the Lord. I desire it. I want it, and I'm going after it, that I may dwell in the house of the Lord forever and to inquire in his temple. I am not asking anybody to move house and come and live in this building, but I want to say to you this evening, establish a relationship with Jesus Christ. Let Holy Spirit come into you, and you will be ever in his presence. And wherever you go, whatever you do, whatever you come out against, you know you can find comfort because of the relationship that you have established. The presence of the Lord is important. Another thing I want you to think about, you have to trust in the strength and the power of God. He said, the rod represents God's power, God's authority, God's strength. He is sovereign God. We can't determine what will happen or what wouldn't happen. He is sovereign God, but we could trust him. So trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not to your own understanding, but in all your ways acknowledge him, and he will direct your path. Trust in the strength and power of the Lord. It is in his strength that we will be able to move. It is in him we live and move and have our being. All of us here in this house this evening, whether we accept Jesus Christ, whether we acknowledge him as Lord or not, you are operating on his strength. Not one of you could wake yourself up. You are operating on his breath. It is his breath in your lungs that you're breathing. And he needs to be thanked for it. He needs to be appreciated for it. You need to give him back. I think it already says, how can I not love him back? Then he loved me so. We do it in natural. You love me, I love you back. Jesus loved you. Love you enough to die for you. Love him back. And you love him back, not by saying it, but by serving him, by giving him the chance to be Lord of your life. So I need you to establish a relationship with him. I need you to experience his presence and desire his presence. And I need you to trust in the strength and the power of God. And not only that, give him the chance to lead you. He said, your rod and your staff. What does the staff do for the shepherd? Keep the sheep in line. And so the staff here is symbolic of the guidance and the leadership of our Heavenly Father. I believe all of us here are at the age where we sign the song in school. Lead us, Heavenly Father, lead us. All this world's tempestuous sea. Come on. So we know that the world is going to be rough. It is going to be challenging. Because of the enemy. But glory be to God, we have somebody that we could trust. And I offer him to anybody here this evening who don't know him. So yes, we take some time to thank God for our sister Sandiford, Mother Sandiford, Auntie Precious, whatever we want to call her. Her life has been a testimony that the Lord is her shepherd. As a member of this assembly, I can't stand here to tell you that she ever stood here to preach a sermon. I can't tell you that she ever was a worship leader. But I can tell you that everybody who interacted with her, regardless of what level, knew that she knew the word of the Lord and she trusted in it. Knew that she loved to sing the praises and the goodness of God. Those from the visitation committee can tell me about the many times they would go, even back in Sister Colleen's time, and when they start a word, she will lead the discussion because she is into her Bible and she understood and knew the word. And she did not allow being shut in to keep her from being in contact. She followed our services and she kept in relationship. You know, you have some people who you belong to a church and you're homesick and you will get vexed and say, nobody ain't call me. Not Aunt Precious. Because if we miss it, she will call. Hallelujah. If the group sister Lord was telling me, she would call her on a regular basis. But if she missed the call, she calls, I ain't hear you lately. I can tell you, Aunt Precious did it for me. She never forget my birthday. My birthday would come and I wonder how she remember my birthday. But every year, if she miss it, she will only miss it if she come a day early. I said, what about? She never forgot. That was the kind of love that she had for people. If she was I remember she wanted to, you talked just now about Vaughn Pepsi. We call her Pepsi, your name going from me. But she would communicate with her, and then one day somehow she couldn't find Pepsi, so she called me. We're trying to get hold of Pepsi, can't get hold of Pepsi. So I have to find somebody that I can find near where Pepsi live to get some, and that we found out then that Pepsi was somewhere else because of sickness at that point in time. But this is the woman that we are talking about. And it wasn't because she was a malicious, wicked woman. It was a woman who had love. A woman who understood how to appreciate people. And so I am telling you, that only comes from the love of God. The love of God is shed abroad in your heart by Holy Spirit. And so she wasn't one picking out, well, I like this one, but not that, and that kind of thing. She understood how to appreciate God's creation. I challenge us this evening, because we are in a world where we are selfish. We are in a world where we want to deal with people based on who they are. But within the body of Christ, there's no room for that. Because I always say, only one set of blood flowed from Calvary. Hallelujah. The same blood that washed the prostitute will wash the body that never do nothing wrong, only sinful by nature. Hello? Only one set of blood. And so, if you're going to relate to me in heaven, you better relate to me down here. In the name of Jesus. So, as we remain in contact, I thank God for her life. She understood how to stay in relationship. And one thing she will always say, if it had not been for the Lord on my side. I don't know a lot about her past and her youth or nothing like that. I don't know a lot about what she would have experienced. But she knew that had it not been for the Lord, her life, her story would have had a different ending. And I stand here today to say the same thing. But for the mercies of God, there go I. It is His grace that kept me so that my story is not as flowery, as flowered as some other people. It is God's grace. And not because we were so good, but His grace kept us. So when we didn't walk that path, don't think we were so strong that we did it. God's grace, His mercy, the everlasting God, the one that we can trust Him. So I challenge us this evening. She knew the Lord as Savior. She trusted in His strength and in His power. And she trusted in His leadership to guide her. I challenge us, let this be your decision. Young people, grandchildren, it was nice to have you reading and singing. I don't know what your relationship with God is, but I tell you, if you don't know Him as Savior, do something about it. Because that's the only way you will ever come into contact and share fellowship again with her. The Bible tells me we can know as we are known. So in a case of where I ain't gonna know that's Aunt Precious. We can know it's Aunt Precious, right? Hallelujah. But like that story with the rich ruler and the beggar, this is the dividing line. If we don't go down like her, we can't meet up with her. But the only way we do that, and this is not to frighten you, this is just to challenge you, that let the love that she showed you challenge you to choose her way of life. Choose the path that she has chosen. Choose her God. Choose to trust Him. Choose to establish a relationship with Him, means that you will talk to Him. And choose to give Him the ability to guide you. The young girl sang, Lord, I give you my heart. I give you my soul. And that song goes on, I live for you alone. Every breath I take, every moment I am awake, Lord, have your way in me. So anybody wants to ask Him to have His way so that you can experience His comfort, for the Lord is my comfort. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow, not death yet, the shadow. Hello? Ain't get here yet, but all this is the shadow. This life of trouble and tribulations and challenges, all this is the shadow. And here do I walk through. I will fear no evil, for the Lord is with me. His rod and staff,
comfort me. Can we bow our heads in the presence of the Lord? If you're here this afternoon and you want our precious God to be your God, while our eyes are all closed, just push your hand in the air. I will pray a special prayer for you. As we give God thanks for being the great God that He is, the merciful God, God that looks beyond our faults and see our needs. So even now, Heavenly Father, we come into your presence and we say thank you again for this life. Thank you for your word that reminds us that we can have relationship with you through that great gift of salvation. I pray that the light of the gospel of Jesus Christ will shine into every heart in this house, every heart that may be hearing on the platform. God, every heart that does not yet know you, that may be hardened, I pray, God, that it would be softened this evening and the word will be able to penetrate and light will come into darkness, that they may be able to acknowledge you as Lord and Savior. We thank you again for her life and we pray, God, that as we continue to live on this side, that you will stay with us. Holy Spirit, you will guide us. And let nothing we do or say bring dishonor to you. Bless this congregation, Father. We thank you for every spiritual leader in this house. God, that you will so bless them and equip them that as we continue in this troublesome world, we will stand up for righteousness. We will stand up for holiness. And we will be able to impact as many as you have called. Take all honor, take all glory, and take all praise. In Jesus' name. Amen. If the immediate family would just stand and family members just stand as we breathe a special prayer for you today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, your people are standing before you. They have been touched by our precious life in some way or another. Today, they grieve her passing. They feel the pain and the loss of not being able to relate to her like they would have in the past. And it is natural to feel grief. It is natural to feel pain and to feel hurt. But I pray, God, that no one will get angry with you in the name of Jesus. But that we will all accept and acknowledge that you have the final say. And it has pleased you at this time to call her to rest. I pray that as they continue to live in this life, that you would bless them with love one for another. That they will be able to carry on any family traditions that she had established. And that her wishes, oh God, they will be able to oblige her with the wishes that she would have left. That they will unite as one. And more so, God, they will all choose you as Lord. I pray for these young people, oh God, young men and young women that stand here singing and declaring today. God, I don't know their relationship with you, but I thank you that you know them by name and nature. And I pray for them today, God, that where their hearts are softened, God, that you will draw them to you. As you comfort them naturally, God, they will experience that spiritual renewal. In the name of Jesus. And I give you thanks for doing all that you will do for this family. Strengthen them as they go through this last rite of laying their body in the earth. God, that is when it hits hardest. But right now I say, let your strength be theirs in the name of Jesus. Let the joy of knowing that she is at rest with you be their comfort. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. We're going to do our last song as we prepare to leave. We are going out on a point of rejoicing. Come unto me. Hear the blessed Savior calling the oppressed. Were you heavy laden, come to me and rest. Come, no longer tarry. I, your Lord, will bear. Bring me every burden. Bring me every care. Let us all stand. We're going to stop after the third verse and do a benediction, and then we will have our recessional.
Father, we thank you. As we prepare to leave, we ask for your protection and your journey of mercies. Now may the grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen.
Have you by temptation often come with me as a sense of weakness brought distressing? I will sanctify you if you confess. In the Holy Spirit, he will give you rest. Come unto me, and I will give you rest.
Lord God most holy, O Lord most mighty, O holy and most merciful Savior, deliver us not into the bitter pains of eternal death. For as much as it has pleased Almighty God in his wise providence to take out of this world the soul of our departed sister, we therefore commit her body to the ground. Earth to earth, ashes to ashes, dust to dust, looking for the general resurrection in the last day and the life of the world to come through our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose second coming in glorious majesty to judge the world, the earth and the sea shall give up their dead, and the corruptible bodies of those who sleep in him shall be changed and made like unto his own glorious body, according to the mighty working whereby he is able to subdue all things unto himself. Join me as we say the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. I don't know if you want to lay your roses. You're laying your roses now. Our first hymn would be "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." May we give them an opportunity to just go and lay their roses.
Thank you. clouds will overspread the sky.
But when traveling days are over, not a shadow, not a sign.
When we all get to heaven,
yeah. keeping trusting ever till I reach a golden strand just beyond the river. In the cross, be my glory ever till my raptured soul shall find rest beyond.
Let us pray. O merciful God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and the life, in whom whosoever believeth shall live though he die, And whosoever liveth and believeth in him shall not die eternally. Who also have taught us by his holy apostle St. Paul not to be sorry as men without hope for those who sleep in him. We humbly beseech thee, O Father, to raise up from the death of sin unto the life of righteousness, that when we shall depart this life, we may rest in him, and that at the general resurrection in the last day, we may be found acceptable in thy sight, and receive that blessing which thy well-beloved Son shall then pronounce to all who love and fear thee, saying, Come, ye blessed children of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the beginning of the world. Grant this, we beseech thee, O merciful Father, through Jesus Christ, our mediator and redeemer. Amen. May we all say the grace, may the grace of our Lord, of the Holy Spirit, rest and abide with us now and forevermore. Amen. May she rest in peace and rise in glory. God bless you. May continue to support. You're now welcome to...
Himself of all the love and blessed. I love you, Lord, for your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. Of the goodness of God. I love your voice. You have led me through the fire, and in darkest night you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend. I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful.
Oh, yes, you have.
And all my life you have been so, so good. Every breath that I am able, the goodness of God.